In today's video, I want to talk about Bitcoin. As computer science enthusiasts, we often get asked some weird questions about technology. Usually, it's toddlers or old people. I'm not gonna bother with the questions from toddlers. Well, because, let's be honest, you can always lie to them. They'll believe anything. Instead, I want to focus on the questions we get from old people. I'll use my father as an example. One day he asked me, "Who owns Bitcoin?" I told him, "Well, no one owns it. That's the whole point. It's beyond governments and centralized control." But then he countered with, "Okay, but who invented it?" Now that's a logical question, and to be honest, hard one to answer. So I decided to do everyone a favor and answer it once and for all in this video. That way, if you ever get asked the same thing, you can just refer to them here and save yourself the effort. Let's start by rewinding to 2008. The world was in the middle of a financial crisis, banks were failing, governments were printing money like there was no tomorrow, and people were losing the trust in the traditional financial system. Then out of nowhere, someone using the pseudonym Satoshi Nakamoto published a Bitcoin white paper. In the white paper, Satoshi proposed a decentralized, peer-to-peer currency. No banks, no intermediaries. Just people, computers, and math. The white paper wasn't just brilliant, it was revolutionary. It laid the groundwork for Bitcoin, and by extension, the entire cryptocurrency industry. But here is the weird part. After releasing the software in 2009 and working on it for a couple of years, Satoshi just disappeared. No goodbye tweet, no I'm retiring blog post, nothing. The last known communication from Satoshi was in April 2011. Naturally, people have spent years trying to figure out who Satoshi is. And oh boy, the theories are wild. I won't go through all of them to not make this video unnecessarily long, but let's first look at the first three main suspects. Hal Finney was a legendary cryptographer and one of the first people to adapt Bitcoin. He even received the first ever Bitcoin transaction from Satoshi himself. Some people think Hal might be Satoshi, but he always denied it. Sadly, Hal passed away in 2014, taking any secrets he might have had to the grave. Also, one thing to note that Hal was cryogenically frozen after his death. So who knows? If technology advances far enough, maybe we can ask him again and watch him probably deny it all over again. Next, we have Dorin Satoshi Nakamoto. I know what you're thinking. Hold on, you just said the name was a pseudonym, and now you're telling me that there's an actual guy named Satoshi Nakamoto? Well, yes. Dorin Satoshi Nakamoto is a retired physicist living in California. And he also happened to live just a few blocks away from Hal Finney. Coincidence? Maybe. But does that make him Satoshi? Probably not. First of all, Dorin denied everything. He said he had no idea what Bitcoin was until journalists started showing up at his door. And honestly, the poor guy just wanted to live a quiet life. And also, let's be real, just look at him. He genuinely looks like someone who has no clue what Bitcoin is. Next up, we have Nick Szabo, a computer scientist and cryptographer who created something called BitGold in 1998. You can think of it as a precursor to Bitcoin. What makes this theory interesting is that the writing style of Satoshi's white paper is very similar to Szabo's writing style. Is it just a coincidence? Again, maybe. If you're into conspiracies, this one is pretty solid. But one thing to note, he has publicly stated that he prefers to keep his privacy and focus on his work rather than entertain the speculations. And finally, we can't forget the internet's favorite theories. First, Satoshi's Elon Musk. Why not? He's a tech genius, a disruptor, and loves a good mystery. But Musk denies it. And let's face it, he's not so great at keeping secrets. Next, Satoshi is the CIA. A tool for surveillance? Sure, it's plausible. But why make it open source if they wanted the full control? Finally, Satoshi is an alien. Specifically, an alien with an holy motive to save us from ourselves. Now that we have covered all the main theories, let me make an important point first. As evidenced by the internet's favorite theories, people are stupid. Okay, now that we have firmly established this point, let's circle back to our main question. Who invented Bitcoin? And here is the answer, who cares? Now, hear me out before you call me crazy. Bitcoin was designed to be decentralized, a currency that doesn't rely on banks, governments, or even a single person. If we found out who Satoshi was, wouldn't that go against everything Bitcoin stands for? Also, Satoshi's Bitcoin wallet still holds about 1 million BTC. That's roughly around $100 billion at today's price. If Satoshi's identity were revealed, that person would suddenly have enormous influence over Bitcoin's value. It could destabilize the entire market. The beauty of the Bitcoin is that it's bigger than any one person. It doesn't need a central figure. Its mantra is simple: trust the code, not the people. And I couldn't agree more. In a way, Satoshi's decision to remain anonymous was the ultimate power move. By stepping away, they, because let's be honest, it couldn't have been just one person. They ensured that Bitcoin would thrive without them. It's no longer their creation. It's ours. Thank you guys for watching. I know that you forgot to like and subscribe, but I'll see you in another video.